In this video, we're going to have a really quick look at question hierarchy. Now, what do I mean with question hierarchy? When I was looking at the paper form, I noticed actually that service charges is section 2.1, meaning that it's actually part of access to health. So it's a subsection to access to health. So how does that translate in our survey? Well, if we just go to our survey, collapse all the questions, we see access to health here and service charges here. Opening up access to health, obviously we see this subsection, which is actually the question table, and this one. But service charges should also be inside access to health. So how do we do that? We can just drag it up until we see the green tick, and also note the arrow. The arrow is pointing directly at access to health. Now, when I drop service charges into access to health, we can see that the hierarchy goes down here. We see that service charges is directly below access to health, as opposed to previously when it was here, meaning or implying that it would be a separate section. But in actual fact, as we mentioned, it's actually part of access to health. It's a subsection of access to health, and therefore it should be inside the access to health question group. And we can see when we collapse access to health, our service charges group disappears. So I'll show you now what the difference is when we actually export the data, and I'll also show you quickly why this is such an advantage in Power BI when we start using, when we start creating dashboards at a later stage. So having exported the data, I can see that there have been 8 form submissions so far, and scrolling over, we can see here what our table looks like. So the table I'm talking about is this question: how many days per week and or hours per day are the following services provided? And then within that we had all of these variables, and then within each variable we had the number of days, some questions about 24-hour care, and average patient waiting time. So how does that translate into ComCare? So we always have the form dot qualifier in front of our column names for the questions that we inserted. So this is great. So it means that it's really easy for us to separate out the questions that we put into the form versus the metadata, such as start time or username. And then we have our access to health. So if we take a look at our survey, okay, that's this level. Okay, so access to health. Then next down the line should be how many days per week and or hours per day are the following services provided. Now granted, we could have made this smaller. We could have probably just said services provided. That would have been easier. But either way, I mean, it's going to be very easy for us to find questions related to this table once we're working in Power BI. So, and that's what we see here. How many days per week and or hours per day are the following services provided? Then we have our variable, so VCT in this case, right? And then within VCT, we have days per week that the service is provided. So that's this question, right? So then the next one over should have that same question path, but it should be the next question. So is 24-hour care provided? So let's see. So once again, we have form, then we have access to health, then we have how many days per week and or hours per day are the following services provided, VCT, and is 24-hour care available. Great, so that makes sense. Next one over, same thing, all the way up to VCT, but then how many hours a day is the service provided in the case that it's not a 24-hour service. The next one is average patient waiting time in minutes, and notice that we still have VCT. So it's a very, very structured data table that we have here. It's going to be very, very easy to find the relevant columns when we're working in Power BI. So and then obviously it goes on to other. And then we get to our form.accesstohealth.servicecharges. So let's see what that is. That has to be this one. And obviously the question group itself isn't going to show up as a separate column, but it's the first question within the question group. And that's what we see here. So we named this one service charges, the group, and we named the question service charges, which is why we have this funny looking column called accesstohealth.servicecharges.servicecharges. Also, you might be wondering, why are these questions, why do they all have the three hyphens? Well, that is because we didn't actually fill out any data for these questions yet. I created a new export without actually having tested the data, and this obviously relates to the previous times when these questions weren't yet available. Okay, so next question over, form.accesstohealth.servicecharges.indicate the fees for the following services dot consultation OPD. So let's see, does that make sense? Yes, look, we have access to health, service charges, indicate the fees for the following service, consultation OPD. So that entire question path is stored in the column name. Access to health, service charges, indicate the fees, consultation OPD. So we know exactly what these questions refer to. So how does this help us in Power BI? Well, let's say we want to make a chart showing, for example, the average number of days that the health facility is open or the average patient waiting time per department or service. In that case, when we go to our query editor, we can reference our raw data, and then we say something like table question. And then when I go to choose columns, I can unselect everything, keep my form ID, and just search for this, how many days per week, etc., etc. So how many days? Ah, and there we go. It's already found all of the questions relating to that table. So now I can simply just select all the search results and have a nice clean query with only the results from our table question. So in the old way of working, you know, if you're trying to analyze data from Excel, sure, I can see how these long names are quite annoying, because you have a lot of data to scroll through. In Power BI, however, the more information you have, the more data you have, the easier it is to work with.